Good morning and welcome to Kollel Baruch Ahavat Israel. ברוכים הבאים. We first and foremost want to welcome you all. Please, first and foremost, as usual, we'd really appreciate you being with us. And we want to say thank you to, you know, some of our good friends and sponsors that helps us bring Torah every day and the words of God to everybody. We really thank you all for being with us. We do also a blessing for Refuah Shelema, Be'ezat Hashem, a Refuah for Baruch Chai Ben Chaya Miriam, a Refuah Be'ezat Hashem to Zehavit Batova, Refuah Shelema to Flori Bat Rachel, Karen Bat Aliza, Bat Sheva Bat Aziza, משה בן מרסל, יצחק בן אלה, אורי אור בן ענת, פנחס בן רחל, ובעזרת השם מחלוף בן משה, ולכל חולי עמך ישראל, אל נרפן עליהם, אל נרפן עליהם, אל נרפן עליהם. So today we're going to learn about אליהו הנביא and אלישע. Eliyahu and Elisha. You know, he basically the so-called second in command. It was after Eliyahu Hanavi. Eliyahu the prophet, as we know, is a reincarnation of Pinchas. Pinchas, as mentioned in the Torah, he is the one that basically saved the people of Israel, and he merited to come back in a reincarnation of Eliyahu Hanavi. And now in his physical life, he's going up to the heavens alive. So the Torah, we're looking at the book of Melachim, the book of Kings 2. We are on the second chapter. And it says, ויהי בעלות אדוני את אליהו בסערה השמיים, וילך אליהו ואלישע מן הגלגל. So, you know, the Torah will tell us that now אליהו הנביא and Elijah, his, the prophet that helps him and with him, they are together now going to what we call the location where אליהו הנביא will go up to the heaven alive. The Torah says that they left the Gilgal, הלכו מן הגלגל. It's also, the Gilgal is also Gilgul, is a reincarnation. It will speak to us about the powers of Pinchas that became Eliyahu Navi, and Be'ezat Hashem, Eliyahu Navi then will come and announce Mashiach. So it says, ויומר אליהו אל אלישע, שב נא פה, כי אדוני שלחני עד בית אל. ויאמר אלישע, חי אדוני וחי נפשך עם מעזבך, וירדו לבית אל. So Eliyahu says to his so-called helper, that is a prophet too, but not a full prophet yet. He says, listen, stay here. I'm going to go somewhere. Hashem told me to go to a place, בית אל. בית אל זה מקום ליד ירושלים. It's a place by Jerusalem. And it's actually known as the opening to what we call, there is a world that we don't see there. This is the opening to heaven, Gan Eden. And we know Hashem, the word Olam. Olam min ne'elam. It's something we don't see, right? Something that's missing, right? And Eliyahu Navi says, I have to go there. I have to go to a place called Bet El. By the way, this Bet El is also mentioned with King Solomon. It's mentioned in the Torah. It's mentioned many places. And Elisha says, no, I'm not staying here. I'm coming with you. Eliyahu says to him, stay here. I have to go. He says, no, I am not staying here. I'm coming with you. So they go now from the Gilgal, which is up the northern part of Israel, to Jerusalem. Now, I want you to know that when they go to travel, they're not walking. They actually do time travel. Because we see they've been all over Israel within hours. And walking back then could take days and days and days. There was no cars, no airplanes. ויצאו בני הנביאים אשר בית אל אל אלישה, ויאמרו אליו, הידעת כי היום אדוני לוקח את אדונך מער ראשך? The prophets, there were 50 prophets that were in a place that came to Beit El, and they said to Elisha, did you know that today your rabbi, the prophet Eliyahu Navi, is going to the heavens? Did you know that? ויאמר, גם אני ידעתי. Echeshu says, yes, I heard, hurry up, let's go. So we see that he knew a lot of prophecies, but not at the level of Eliyahu Navi yet. ויאמר לו אליהו, אלישע, שב נא פה, כי אדוני שלחני יריחו. Now he says to him, stay here in Beit El. And אלישע says, no, again, I'm coming with you. You know, so I have to go to Jericho. You know, from Beit El to Jericho, that's a walk of almost, it takes about 17 hours. You know, especially if you walk slowly, you don't have a donkey, you don't have a horse or camel, whatever the case may be. And the same thing, Elisha says, וחי נפשך אם אעזבך, ויבוא לרחו. So he goes with him to Jericho. By the way, what is Jericho? The word Yericho comes from the word Yerushalayim, Recho. They could smell in Jericho all the ketoret, the incense that was sacrificed in Beit HaMikdash in Jerusalem, all the way to Jericho. You know, it's about, you know, if I'm not mistaken, almost 44 miles different. They could smell. הם יכולים להריח את קורבנות ואת הקטורת מירושלים עד יריחו. המילה יריחו is ירושלים רחו. It's the smell of Jerusalem. That's what I mean Jericho in Hebrew. And they went to יריחו, ויגשו בני הנביאים אשר ביריחו. Now the other prophets that were in Jericho, again, they come to אלישע, and they ask him the same question. שואלים את אלישע, הנביאים ביריחו, אומרים, הידעת כי היום אדוני לוקח את אדונך? Did you know that God is taking Eliyahu Navi today from you? You know, it's a very odd question. The other prophets ask this in the Beit El. The prophets here in Jericho ask that. What does it ask? Why they ask? So it teaches something amazing. So you know, the Torah, if you read the entire Torah, there's 48 male prophets and 7 women prophetesses. But we see here there's a lot more. The Gemara will tell us there were actually 1.2 million prophets throughout the Torah, which include from Genesis all the way to Divrei HaYamim, to the end of the Bible. And we know it says that for every place there were prophets, and those prophets came to actually justify the real prophets. They were real, but there was a higher level of prophecy. And for every prophet, like you had, like Eliyahu Navi, or Elisha, or Shmuel, all those prophets, they had thousands of prophets saying, yes, this is the real prophet. What he's saying is the words of God, because they all had the same knowledge. And of course, he says to them, Elisha, yes, I know, Shamati. Yadati Hecheshu, the same thing he says to them. I heard, now hurry up, come with us. Vayomer lo Eliyahu, shev na po hayom, ki Adonai shelachani hayardena. He says, Hashem, send me to the Jordan River. Hayardena, it's, what's hayardena? It's Yarden, hey. I have my nephew Yarden. Baruch Hashem, mezat Hashem, shizkeh lechatuna, tehora vekedosha. וזיווג הגון שמענו, ברוך השם, כל הכבוד. ירדנה is ירדן היי. The letter ירדן, the word ירדן with the letter of היי of השם. Every time that, let's say, a person go, a tzaddik goes to a place that could be dangerous, השם in the Torah add the letter היי. Like, for an example, when Jacob went to Egypt, he says, ויעקב ירד מצרימה. Not מצרים, not Egypt, is מצרימה. Is what we call a hey. The letter of God was added to protect him. Oh, Yaakov, יצא לחרנה. He went to Haran, but hey, Hashem is with him. So every time there is the letter hey added, that means there was a dangerous place, but Hashem was there to guard them. So here too, it says, Vonelech hayardena. But again, Eliyahu Navi says to Elisha, Navi, תישאר פה. הוא אומר לו, לא, אני בא איתך, מה פתאום? חי נפשך, I swear to you on your life, he says, I will have to come with you. I'm going to go with you. And you see that everything that has to do with Elisha is really getting close to his rabbi. It says that when we are devekim b'Hashem, how do we get glued to Hashem? We get glued to the rabbis. We learn from them. Because we don't see Hashem. The rabbis know what it takes to have a person feel Hashem. Teach them the words of God. It says here that Elisha again says, no, I'm not leaving you. וילכו שניהם, וחמישים איש מבני הנביאים הלכו, ויעמדו מנגד מרחוק. They joined 50 other prophets, came with them. By the way, we know even just with Ahav and Isabel, they had, you know, what we call false prophets, 450 false prophets. Here we have 50 real prophets, and they come, they joined Elisha and Eliyahu Navi, and they stand far. Vayamdu mineged. Mineged means on the other side. Merachok, from a distance. Veshnehem amdu ala Yarden. And Elisha and Eliyahu standing on the river banks of the Jordan River. What's Yarden? Yarden is Yarad Dan. It's the water that came from the, what we call Nachalat Dan. Originally, Nachalat Dan was only in Gush Dan, what we call Tel Aviv, was the portion of the tribe of Dan. But there were so many of them that some of them moved to the northern Israel, what we call of Lebanon today. That was part of Israel. It will be again. And it's called, there's a place called Tel Dan, the city of Dan, the mountains of Dan. And there is the river that come from the Hermon. Right? Hermon is the mountain that has snow on it in Israel. And from that, the water come through Yarad Dan, come from the tribe of Dan. Hamayim yordim mishevet Dan, lachen nikra Yarad Dan. And the water supplies to all Israel, to even, you know, Jordan, all the way to, you know, the Kinneret, the Sea of Galilee, down to the, you know, so-called the Dead Sea, Yam HaMelech, the Sea of Salt. So it says, ויקח אליהו את אדרתו ויגלום ויקה על המים. אליהו, אדרתו, by the way, means his talit. He takes his talit and he covers, and he takes his staff and he hits on the Jordan River. And he says, ויחצו המים הנה והנה ויעברו בשניהם בחורבה. You know, Moshe Rabbeinu, Hashem split the Red Sea for him. Right? For Joshua, Hashem split the Jordan River, right? But and unlike the Red Sea, the water stood on both sides. But with the river, all you have to do is the one side, because the bottom just flow and there is no water. Here, Eliyahu Navi splits the Yarden, the Jordan River, ויעברו שניהם בחורבה. Chorva means on earth, on the dirt, you know, as we know, Chorva is also meaning Chorev. Chorev is Mount Sinai, but also Chorva meaning dry land. And Vayhi ke'Avraham ve'Eliyahu omer el Elisha, She'al, ma yaseh lecha beterem elakach me'imcha? Eliyahu Navi knows he's about to leave, and he asks his student, you know, Elisha, he says, what can I do for you before I leave? Make a wish, so to speak. Aseh bakasha, ma yaseh lecha, for you. What do you want for you? Beterem elakach mimcha, vayomer Elisha, vayhina pi shnayim beruchacha elai. Elisha, would you kindly close this? Elisha says, I'll tell you what, I want to be double than you. אלישע אומר לאליהו הנביא, אני רוצה להיות יותר טוב ממך פעמיים, כפול שתיים. This is a very odd request. right? You say, maybe you should say, I should be like you. I want to be like you. But Elisha has the chutzpah to say, I want to be twice as good as you. We need to learn from that. מה זאת אומרת, אלישה? אליהו הנביא אומר לו, תגיד לי, מה אתה רוצה? אני אעשה איזה נס בשבילך, מה אתה רוצה? הוא אומר לו, אני רוצה להיות כפול ממך פעמיים, אני רוצה יותר טוב ממך. I want to be double as you. אליהו הנביא, in his life, had many, many miracles, but 8 major ones, 8 נסים גלויים, ענקים, אליהו הנביא עשה בחייו, and אלישה did 16. So we see here that really, it's okay to ask for more. Hashem says, ask, don't be shy. The Arizal Omer, the Arizal says, if somebody asks, how are you? Say, good, but I want to be too better. It's good to ask for more. Hashem likes to give more. If you deserve it. Elisha understood, you know what? I deserve it. I want to ask more. I want to be more. I want to be double as Eliyahu HaNavi. I want to be twice as good as you. And we'll see whether he accept that or not and see what happened. And Vayomer hakshita lishol im tarah oti. Omer lo, you give me a very tough task. Mashu kashe, aval, he says, listen, if you see me, he give him a rule. He says, whatever you ask is tough, but אם תראו אותי לוקח מאיתך, יהיה לך כן, ואם אין, לא יהיה. He says, if you saw me taken from earth to the heavens, if you see that sight, so your request will be granted. אומר לו אליהו הנביא, אם תראו אותי עובר מהעולם הזה לעולם הרוחניות, אז מה שביקשת יתקיים. כי אם אתה מסוגל לראות את המעבר הזה, זה אומר שאתה באמת תהיה כפול ממני. וכך היה. He saw him, he says, if you see me transferring from this, what we call physical world, through the spiritual world. If you see that, if you have this sight, if Hashem give you this kind of ability, then yes, your request will be granted. ואם אין לא יהיה, but if you don't see me, then it would not happen. ויהי הם הולכים הלוך ודבר, they start talking now. The Gemara will tell us that Eliyahu Navi was giving him a lot of, you know, musar, rebuke, how to and what to do and to be careful of things to come. Because he knew he was a prophet and he transferred him a lot of his knowledge. והנה רכב אש וסוסי אש, says all of a sudden there is a chariot of fire and horses of fire. Come out from the heavens towards the river where they're at. Now, those are very much something that's abnormal. You cannot have a chariot of fire, right, and horses of fire, unless they come from a different place, different realms, different kedusha, different holiness. And only then you would see that who we are as people, we can even reach that level to be on the middle of fire and not burn. This is really the prophecy of the sneh, the burning bush that Moshe Rabbeinu saw. He says, there's a fire in a bush. Hasneh boer ve'enenu hukal. The Torah will tell us that when Moshe Rabbeinu saw on Mount Sinai the burning bush, he looked at it and said, something is not normal here. And he went to examine. Because when you have fire, everything burns. Especially a bush. A bush burns, it becomes dust. Right? Ashes of fire. They said, this is what happened here. Eliyahu Navi is like this siach, this bush. This is the thing that burning but not diminished, not consumed. And he says, "Vayfardu ben shnehem." They say goodbye, and "Vayal Eliyahu b'se'ara hashamayim." So we see here that Eliyahu Navi go on top of this chariot of fire as a physical person, not a spiritual, his body, and his spiritual and his physical connect to the spiritual, מתחבר בין הרוח לבין הגשמיות, משיב הרוח ומוריד הגשם. When we have the spirit good in us, then the physical part is holy. And it says, ויעל אליהו בסערה השמיים. Our sages, Rabbi Yosef Mikordovero, the Ramak says, what's Besa'ara? He said, Satan tried to fight him, and Eliyahu Navi won, defeated him, and went to the heavens on a chariot of fire. Ve'elisha ro'eh, Elisha sees. And this is the condition that Eliyahu says. Eliyahu says to him, if you see what is going to happen, you are witness to it, then you're granted your wish you wished. What did he say? He said, I want to be double than you. Now he sees that. But Elisha is very much a very big tzaddik. He's a righteous person. His rabbi going up to the heavens on a chariot of fire. He's not happy. That, you know, I got my wish granted. הוא לא שמח שהוא קיבל מה שקיבל. כתוב בתורה, והוא מצעק, and he yells, my father, אבי, אבי. You know, Eliyahu was not his father. So how do we know? It says that your father in the world here is your physical world father, and your rabbi is your father for the spiritual world, for the world to come. And Elisha reached a level that nothing earthly matters anymore. Of course, he respected his father, but he understood that the real father is really his rabbi, Eliyahu Navi. And he called him Avi, Avi, twice. Avi ba'olam hazeh ve'avi ba'olam haba. My father in this world and the world to come. Rechev Israel hu farashav ולא ראו עוד, ויחזק בבגדיו, ויקראם לשניים קראים. He sees the sight of Eliyahu going up to the heaven on a chariot of fire, and he's basically start mourning. He rips his clothes. That's where we have ויקרא את בגדיו. You know, when we have a funeral, כשיש הלוויה, חותכים, you know, we rip a little cut on the left side by the heart of the clothes, right? Is a sign of mourning, the siman le'avelut. And when we cut this, we learn this from here. Elisha cut his clothes, likra'im, to two pieces. Why? Because he saw Eliyahu Navi is going up and disappearing. But all of a sudden, vayarem et aderet Eliyahu asher nafla me'alav, vayashav vayamod al sfat hayarden. Eliyahu Navi, basically while he was living this earthly world, he threw his talit, this aderet, he threw it to his student Elisha. And he says, because you were able to see me, because he yells and Eliyahu Navi hear and see everything, I'm going to give you this amazing talit that I have that will protect you and provide you double of what I am. As a mitzvah to put the talit every day or to put tzitzit under your clothes. It's really aderet. It's something that makes you adir, something that makes you big and great and good and protects you from all sides of the world. And he takes this aderet, Elisha, take this talit, ויקח את האדרת אליהו אשר נפלה מעליו ויקה את המים. And he does what? He hits the water. ויאמר, איה אדוני אלוהי אליהו אף הוא. He's asking to see Hashem. He says, where is God? It's not חס וחלילה, it's not that he's, you know, an epicurus or says, where is God? He says, you know, you gave me this ability to see that. I would love to see you. Like Moshe Rabbeinu says, I want to see you, Hashem. Right? Moshe says to Hashem, who are you? Can I see who you are? And Hashem showed Moshe just the back of the tefillin. קשר תפילין הראה לעניו. הקדוש ברוך הוא showed משה just the תפילין of the back. ויקה את המים ויחצו הנה והנה ויעבור אלישע. So we see that when this whole thing happened, as remember, this Eliyahu split the river, and now the water returned. And remember, now we have the 50 prophets on one side, Elisha is on the other side. He is on the east and they are on the west. And Elisha needs to come back. He takes the talit, the aderet vayaket hamayim vayachatzu hena vehena vayavor Elisha. So basically he did exactly what Eliyahu Navi did. He hit the river and the river split and he crossed and he came over to the other side. ויראו בני הנביאים אשר בירחו מנגד ויאמרו נח הרוח אלוהיהו על אלישע. The 50 prophets that were on the what we call ערבות יריחו, they were on the what we call western side of Jericho, of the river, the Jordan River, and that's יריחו. And basically they said, wow, we see what he did. They did not see Eliyahu Navi, they just saw the talit of Eliyahu Navi. And they saw Elisha split the river, said definitely he became the same power that Eliyahu Navi had. They didn't know he's double, but they knew that at least he's like Eliyahu. ויבואו אל קראתו וישתחו לו ארצה, they come and they bow to him. ויאמרו לו, הננה יש את עבדך 50 אנשים בני חיל, ילכו נא ויבקשו את אדונך. פן עשו רוח אדוני, והשלחו באחד הערים או באחד הגאיות, ויאמר לא תשלחו. They come and ask this prophet, they said to him, you know, we've seen what we've seen now. And it says, we saw you from Jericho, we were on the other side of Jericho, from the distance. And they saw that the spirits of Elisha, Eliyahu Navi is on Elisha now. And it says to him, you are one of the chosen ones, so to speak. You became like Eliyahu, and here we are 50 that's able to help. Let us go search for this people that's, you know, missing. Perhaps the spirits of Hashem can come and carry him off and hurled him into the mountain of the valleys. They didn't know what happened to Eliyahu. They said, let us look for him. Of course, Elisha ראה את זה, הם לא ראו. והם רוצים לחפש. They want to look for Eliyahu, but no, of course not. Elisha says, don't send them. And of course, they refused and tried to badger him. ויפצירו בו עד בוש. They even tried to even insult him, חס וחלילה. And he got to a point and says, okay, go ahead, send these 50 people for 3 days, ולא מצאו, they went to search 3 days, they could not find. וישובו אליו, והוא יושב ביריחו. Elisha is sitting in Jericho, after the 50 prophet went looking, they could not find, come back. And he says, I told you, don't go. They didn't believe him. Even though they saw that he has the power of Eliyahu Navi to split a river, there's only literally four, you know, as we said, Moshe, Yoshua, Eliyahu, and Elisha, four of the, you know, amazing prophets, they were able to split the water. ויאמרו אנשי העיר אל אלישה, הננה מושב העיר טוב, כאשר אדוני רואה והמים רעים. Because they did not believe him, the water that they had became undrinkable. You know, Jericho, as we say, was really a fortified city. Right, Joshua came and conquered it just with the Kohanim, just with the blowing of the shofar. It was powerful, just the filot, when the Kohanim, for 7 days, they went around every day, they blew the shofar. And the whole walls did not fall. They went sunk into the ground. Until today, you could see that. אפשר לראות היום ביריחו את החומות ששקעו. רק בברכות הכהנים ושופר. לא אפילו בכדור אחד, לא בחץ, לא בכלום. ואנשים עכשיו אומרים, these people, the prophet says, we have salt water, the water we cannot drink, people are gonna die. And of course, Elisha is about to make a very big miracle. Elisha says to them, just bring me a small plate. ויאמר קחו לי צלוחית חדשה ושימו עליה מלח ויקחו אליו. ויצא אל מוצא המים וישלח שם מלח. He said to them, give me a small plate, put salt on it. Let me go to the source of water, where the water comes out. And let me see what I can do, so to speak. But he already knew he's going to be successful. But he wanted to show them that just by the power of miracle and prayers, you can take small plate of salt, pour into a whole so-called source of water, and change the water from being salty to being sweet, to be drinkable. ויצא אל מוצא המים וישלח שם מלח ואומר כה אמר אדוני רפיתי למים האלה לא יהיה משם עוד מוות ומסכלת. He prayed to Hashem and Hashem answered his prayer, says this water will be fixed, you can drink them. This to teach us that, you know, things that have problems for us is because we cause them, right? It's the same place, the water was before good, now it's bad. Why? It's our actions, right? Every day should be a good day when you wake up healthy, Baruch Hashem. But there is bad days and good days. Why? It's up to us what we do that day. How do we treat that day? Every day is a hove, is a present, right? The present is today. You live, it's a gift. Treat it as a present. He said that he prayed to Hashem, וירפו המים עד היום הזה. כדבר אלישע אשר דיבר. Until today, there is a river in Jericho, this be'er that gives sweet water in the desert. You know, Jericho is in the desert. Until today, יש נחל ובאר שנותנים מים מהימים האלה. This is like, you know, almost 3,900 years ago. Almost 4,000 years ago. So we see, I'm sorry, 3,000 years ago. So we see that when a miracle happened, it could sustain a lifetime. ויעל משם בית אל והוא עולה בדרך, ונערים קטנים יצאו מן העיר והתקלסו בו. Now he leaves Jericho and he goes up, and young, what we call נערים, teenagers, but when the Torah says נער, is not really, it could be a very old person but have no knowledge of Torah. How do we know? מאיפה אנחנו יודעים שנערים זה לא טיפש עשרה? כתוב בתורה, when Abraham went to the Akedah, right? When he took his son to be sacrificed, he took with him Ishmael, and he took with him Eliezer. Eliezer was older than Abraham. Ishmael was actually, Yitzhak was 36 years old. Ishmael was 13 years old. Older than Yitzchak, 49 years old. But the Torah called Hanarim, meaning they didn't know the Torah. And this so-called Nearim start mocking up Elisha. They called him bold, boldy, boldy. Elisha was kereach. I say, Ale kereach, Ale. They were making fun of him. Have chutzpah, not to honor a prophet. The question is asked, so even though they don't know he's a prophet, but you have to honor elderly, right? Mipnei seva takum, kabed et. What's kabed et? Aleph trutaf. You have to respect everybody. Zaken, the Gemara says, is somebody that older than you by one day. Omerat Gemara zaken, ze ben adam shegadol mincha biyom echad unikra zaken. A person is older than you in one day, is called old person. Even if, let's say I'm 20, he's 20 in one day, is considered zaken, old person. You have to respect him. But because this one had no chutzpah, this na'arim that had no Torah, they start mocking him and insulting him. ויפן אחריו ויראם ויקללם בשם אדוני. אלישע looks at them and ויפן אחריו. What's ויפן אחריו? And he looked behind him. He looked what things to come and he cursed them, and all of a sudden two bears came out from the yard. He says bear and forest. לא דובים ולא יער. You heard the term says no bears and no forest, right? In Hebrew we had לא דובים ולא יער. Elisha made a miracle. He created bears and forest in Jericho, in the desert. ותפקענה מהם, it says, they come and they killed 42 kids. The bears killed all this children that cursed him and mocked him. וילך משם הר הכרמל ומשם שב שומרון. From that he went to the Carmel mountain and he comes to Shomron. And I want to finish with this because we have another class coming. The reason I did the class about the prophets, we have to understand today כל מה שהנביאים אומרים קורה. Everything that the prophet said, it's happening in our days, in our life. A lot of chaos in the world. We have to understand, Hashem would love to, of course, as we know, have a peaceful world. And we cause, chas v'chalila, not so peaceful world. Why? Because we left Hashem. When we leave Hashem, we create chaos, because then the angels above fighting. Every nation has an angel. And we see now the angels of America fighting the angel of Iran, the angel of Lebanon fighting the angels of Israel. You see all kinds of, you know, catastrophes in the world. Africa, Europe, China, Taiwan, there is Syria, Crimea, Ukraine. You see all the problems. Morocco with the Sahara Desert. You have Iraq, you have Iran, you have Libya, you have, you know, all these regions in the world have wars. This is because we left Hashem. So, Be'ezat Hashem, there is one prophet left that never died. Eliyahu Navi. Eliyahu will come and announce Mashiach, Be'ezat Hashem. So, I want to thank you. Please share the class with everybody. I'm Rabbi Dahan. Kolel Baruch Avat Israel. Thank you so much for being with us. And please share the class and join us. We have Be'ezat Hashem another class, Mishnayot, and tomorrow, of course, and every day. So we have a wonderful Shabbat coming upon us. This is Rosh Chodesh Av, the head of the month of Av, which is Av, is acronym Elul Ba, Rashi Tevot, Av Elul Ba. And it's also the memorial day for Aharon Avinu. Aaron passed away in Aleph Be'av. It's a yard site, Yom Askara Le'Aharon Avinu, Zichrono Livracha. So light and Ner Neshama before Shabbat on Friday night, Be'ezat Hashem, in his honor. Thank you so much. Please visit our website, nesatorah.org. We have our YouTube channel, and please share the class with everyone. Thank you so much, and happy Rosh Chodesh.